The light bulb. Despite being a seemingly simple device that most in this world are familiar with, light does not often shine on this object's history, one of innovation in a time of literal darkness and historical precedence for countless future creations. Device that defines our lives through the light that it emits, light bulbs are some of the most commonplace items in the world. Everyone grew up learning about the revered Thomas Edison, the supposed creator of the light bulb, who, in a time where the scientific community was relatively inefficient in their findings, publicly demonstrated the applicability of his supposed creation, the bulb, to thousands of people, just weeks after inventing it. However, what many fail to realize is that almost a century prior to October 18th, 1878, the day when Edison first began his research on the light bulb, another man had made it his mission to control light. In 1802, Humphrey Davy invented the first light-controlling device, which resembled an electric light more than it did the standard bulb that we see today. Wanting to experiment with electricity, Davy took a battery and proceeded to connect it to a piece of carbon using two wires. What resulted was that very piece of carbon glowing, emitting light and heat, a result which he didn't expect and certainly didn't understand. Thankfully, Humphrey Davy's involvement with the creation of the light bulb stopped shortly after his exciting discovery and lackluster understanding of the matter itself. Over the next four decades, various physicists from across the globe attempted to explain and perfect the scientific phenomenon of light, though most were unsuccessful. In 1840, a good old British chap by the name of Warren De La Rue enclosed a coil platinum filament in a vacuum tube and passed an electric current through it. His idea was that the platinum, with an extremely high melting point, would be able to emit light in a safe manner without burning, while the tube would act as a chamber to limit the flow of gas molecules in the system, increasing the longevity of the device. However, although his works were certainly groundbreaking and a lovely improvement to the halt on light-related innovation that had been seen previously, platinum's extremely high cost made it impossible for his creation to make it to the commercial level, let alone out of his own lab. Fast forward another few decades, and we arrive to Henry Woodward. Building off of the various other designs seen throughout the century, Woodward came to the conclusion that if he tried every possible combination of carbon and nitrogen, something was bound to work eventually. And he was right. Of course, this is an exaggeration. However, it wasn't very far from the truth. After months of experimenting, Henry eventually created a lamp, the centerpiece of which was a chunk of carbon, held in between two electrodes, all of which were inside of a glass cylinder. However, despite being a more efficient lamp than previous ones that had been created, once again, his attempts to commercialize the project were unsuccessful, and he eventually sold his patent for the creation to another scientist. To whom? I'll give you a hint. His name starts with a Thomas and ends with an Edison. In 1878, Thomas Edison began researching both the significance and shortcomings of the previous physicists who all failed at creating a viable lamp. First, he bought the only patent to the idea. Then, that same year, applied for his own patent, outlining a device that provided a, quote, improvement in electric lights. However, he didn't stop there, and in 1879, Edison further innovated upon the creation he had bought from Woodward, making a carbon filament that interacted with various platinum wires in order to exude light. Although original documents show that the invention initially used wood splits, paper, and linen thread to create the filament, Edison's team eventually discovered a carbonized bamboo filament that could last for over 1,200 hours. This marked the beginning of what we now call the bulb and its first commercial appearance. From there, Edison realized the tremendous potential of the device and founded the Edison Electric Light Company, which marketed the product to establishments, homes, and people all across the world. The rest? Well, it's history.
As always, this is Kilo November 6, India India Hotel, signing off.